Ja, da sind wir wieder zurück. Ich musste auf Spiel neu starten klicken, weil einfach nichts passiert ist.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
So, und wir kriegen eine Errungenschaft, wenn wir fünfmal die Tür anklicken. Drei,
Oh, please.
vier.
Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door five times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No, 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 no. I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly five clicks.
Okay.
Now suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition.
Eins, zwei, drei, vier, fünf, sechs, sieben, acht, neun, zehn. 11, 12, 13,
I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause.
So, ich klicke jetzt einfach so lange, ich zähle gar nicht mehr mit.
Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks.
So, 50 will er jetzt haben. Ich zähle gerade nicht mit, ich klicke einfach. Ich klicke der Tür jetzt das Hirn raus. Yay, Tür. Das willst du doch auch. Du willst es doch auch. Lass uns klicken.
No, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
Ich will aber hier jetzt... Warte mal, 417, die ist nicht hier, die ist irgendwo anders. Und da 20 mal klicken. Tür 417. Ah, hier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Ich mache 20. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So, mach mal 21, hält besser. Jetzt sollen wir auf 437 klicken. Und das Spiel steuert uns jetzt komplett schon.
Excellent. I think we're getting somewhere. Now door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so.
Okay. Warum nicht? 415. 2. 3,
Now back to door
4,
number 437.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So. Jetzt schnell wieder zurück. Schnell wieder zurück. Oh mein Gott. Es ist ja so aufregend.
Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, the copy machine. Alright, back to room 417. I'm really feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere.
Es wird irgendwie immer absurder.
Okay, now go climb on employee 419's desk.
41. Hier.
Yes, this is great. You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on door 416.
Yay, die kannst du haben, mein Freund.
We've almost got it. Now the copy machine, do that one again.
Oh Gott, nein. Wir müssen wieder zum Kopierer zurück. Ah.
Finish it off, Stanley. Five clicks on door 430.
Yes. Yay.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. Stanley. Nothing could hold you back. Yes, I'm very proud of how far we've come today. Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth five little clicks. Really now, what were you thinking?
Ist das ein Scheiß? Ach man. Okay, aber wir machen jetzt einfach... Im Grunde muss ich ja nur noch mal in diese Todesszene kommen.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
damit
he entered the door on his left.
Damit ich dieses Ende ja noch mal kriege. Beziehungsweise diese Möglichkeit.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Hoping, coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay, hier können wir nichts eingeben. Schade.
Okay, I think we all know the drill by now. Blah, blah, blah. Dark secrets, the keypad. Stanley pushes some buttons. Oh, hey, look, it's a new passageway. Kill surprise.
Ach. Okay, das Spiel erinnert sich also doch, dass wir was gemacht haben. Okay, jetzt wird's spannend wieder mal. Yay, komm, wir fahren nach unten. Jetzt muss doch ein Ladebildschirm kommen. Und der kommt auch, sehr schön. Okay, das finde ich jetzt aber echt geil irgendwie. Ich dachte eigentlich, dass wir jetzt im Hauptmenü praktisch... Wir sind ja nicht ins Hauptmenü. Ich habe einfach das Spiel neu starten gemacht. Und, aber es ist dann anscheinend wirklich so gewollt, dass wir das so tun. Und deswegen haben wir es jetzt getan. Yay. Und jetzt muss ich eigentlich nur noch mal diese Escape-Route dann wieder darunter springen. Dann sagt ja wieder diese weibliche Stimme was. Und dann, sind wir noch mal in diesem einen...
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Wollen wir da noch mal hingehen oder soll ich lieber... Oh, ich weiß es gar nicht. Ich überlege jetzt gerade, ob ich nicht doch lieber zu dieser Gedanken-Dingens gehe. Ich würde gerne noch mal in diesem Museumsdingens sein. Obwohl, nee, wir gehen jetzt mal doch hier lang.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Und wenn wir es nicht herausfinden wollen.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen. And Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Wo sind wir denn? Da gucken wir doch gleich nochmal, wo unsere Nummer ist. Müsste es nicht irgendwo hier sein? 427 sind wir. Da. Jetzt genau ungefähr in der Mitte des Bildschirms. Jo, sehr schön. Gut, dann gehen wir mal unseren vorgeschriebenen Pfad. Zip.
This mind control facility. It was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No, he refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never! It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content, walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life.
Okay,
for he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Kann ich hier den fetten roten Knopf drücken? Kann ich nicht. Ah, was will das Spiel von mir? Was will dieses Spiel von mir? Ich kann hier Knöpfe drücken, aber es hat überhaupt keine Auswirkung. Aber wirklich null. So.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Wir drücken jetzt mal on. Ich habe das letzte Mal eigentlich hier drauf geklickt und habe das anscheinend irgendwie, wissen nicht, zerstört oder so. Jetzt drücke ich einfach mal on.
Oh, Stanley, You didn't just activate the controls, did you?
Okay.
After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control?
Ja, wir wollen Kontrolle über unser Tun.
I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go. Turn the controls off and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are said to explode, eliminating the entire complex. How long until detonation then? Let's say, 2 minutes. Ah, this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine. You are the star. It's your story now. Shape it to your heart's desires. Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that? You'd like to know where your co-workers are? A moment of solace before you're obliterated? All right, I'm in a good mood. You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story. Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone. Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp. I have to say this, though, this version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go. But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much.
Come on. You
know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock, why not? These are additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh dear me, what's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten? Won? Solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley. You're in for quite a disappointment. But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along. It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble. This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here, just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life, or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count, or don't. It's all the same to me, all a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever up.
Okay. Puh. Und das Spiel startet erneut neu. Nachdem wir, weiß nicht, nachdem der Selbstzerstörungsmechanismus da anscheinend irgendwie die Anlage gesprengt hat. Und wir werden sicherlich gleich wieder in unserem Büro anfangen. Vermute ich jetzt einfach mal. Ja. Eieiei. Das Interessante ist, und das muss man dem Spiel wirklich zugutehalten.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Und jetzt machen wir das, was wir
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ach scheiß, ich würde gerade sagen, nee, lass mal rechts gehen und dann in diesen Fahrstuhl rein. Ach Mann.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Tipps von Ocker, den fired.
Stanley decided to go up to the boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Oh no, not again. I won't be part of this. I'm not going to encourage you. I'm not going to say anything at all. I'm just going to be patient and wait for you to finish whatever it is you enjoy doing so much in this room. Please take your time.
Oh, das Spiel ist so krass. So. Es fesselt einen richtig. Ich muss sagen, man will irgendwie so die ganzen letzten Geheimnisse noch aufdecken. Wir gehen hier mal nach unten.
Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished. His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all. None of it made any logical sense. And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations. For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went? And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating? No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange.
It's not real.
And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He just hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming, he yelled. This is all a dream. Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground. Then
Whoa!
He imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field, and it too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking? Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd, and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself, believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please. It's all I want. I want my apartment, and my wife, and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Stanley began screaming.
Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I?
And everything went black. This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy, this much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Wow. Wow. Oh, das Spiel ist wirklich intensiv. Ach du Scheiße. Ich weiß schon gar nicht mehr, was ich sagen soll. Der Sprecher labert ja die ganze Zeit. Und ich möchte ihm ungern ins Wort fallen. Und ich möchte hier gleich mal noch den Part beenden. Wir sind schon wieder gestorben. Aber was ich super interessant finde, was man im Spiel sehr zugutehalten muss, egal was man tut, es ist immer anders. Wir hatten, glaube ich, noch nicht zweimal die gleiche Sequenz. Also die komplett gleiche Handlung. Das finde ich so interessant. Man ist irgendwie gezwungen, weiterzuspielen, wenn man einfach wissen will, was passiert. Das ist der Hammer. Okay, gut. Dann sehen wir uns im nächsten Part. Tschüss.